Hi everyone. Today I'm going to do a quick tutorial on hidden line rendering in 3ds Max. The render engine I'm using is Mental Ray, but I think this technique can be applied to pretty much any render engine. This came up on the Area forum. Somebody was asking about it, and I found a way to do it, so I thought I'd share it with you. Now, what's different about this than most other techniques is that you're actually only rendering the lines, so you're getting a clean alpha channel, and it's just a lot easier to composite and stuff. The thing about the glow is it was something that was requested specifically, so I added a glare shader on top. We'll go over that as well, just really quickly. I intend to do this in post, but for some reason they wanted to render it with the glare on top, so that can be done as well. As you can see, I've got a really basic shape. I think it was a helix with some modifiers on it. I'll add the scene file as well for you to look at, so you can definitely check it out. So right now, if I press render, I'm not really getting anything spectacular. Just getting the shape, of course. We can see the polygons, so I'll get down to the setup. What we're going to need for this is a gradient ramp map, which we're going to set to box, and set the interpolation to solid. Sorry about that. We're just going to make this black and white, black on the inside, white on the outside. You'll see in a minute why we're doing this. Set it to about, I don't know, 90, 95. Basically, this is how you're going to control the thickness of the lines on your object. How are we going to control it? Well, if we add a UVW map and we set it to face, then our gradient map will basically be mapped to every single face of every single polygon individually. So this way we can create a wireframe effect, but we have a little more control than using the wire shader. The reason, by the way, why I'm not using this standard wire shader is because even if you stick it into a blend shader to do stuff with it, it'll override everything. So you won't actually get a hidden line effect. You'll get the you'll just get the wireframe effect, which isn't what we're after. So now that we have the gradient ramp, let's start making our shaders. First off, I'm going to make a blend. We'll delete the two standard ones that are in it. And for the first shader, we're going to make a matte shadow reflection. So what this is going to do, if we stick it into our first material, basically we're going to create the hidden line effect by matting out all the polygons behind other ones. It'll become clear in a second when we apply the shader. I'm just turning off everything because we don't really need shadows or anything like that, because we're just using the shader to block out everything behind it. And then for the second one, we're just going to use an Arch and Design shader. Now, we got to set our diffuse and our reflectivity to 0, and I'm putting the gradient map in the self-illumination slot. The reason I'm putting it in the self-illumination slot is so I can control the glow afterwards. So if you want to do the glow in post and you don't really have any need for self-illumination, you can set your diffuse level to 1 and use the gradient ramp in that channel. Now, just to drive the wires, I'm going to throw in a quick RGB multiply, and what this is going to do is it's going to allow us to give the wires some color as well. So let's say we'll make it orange like in the example, throw it in here, self-illumination map. Of course we're going to have to enable it if we're using this, set it to something like 2 or whatever, and stick the material in the second map slot of the blend shader. Now, the last thing we've got left to do is link up the gradient ramp to the mask, and this will just give the Arch and Design, it'll just let the Arch and Design come through on the wires. So what happens when we apply this to our object, do a quick render, and we see all our wires are showing up and we have a clean alpha channel. Just wait for it to render. So that's it. Really nothing special, but it's a nice way of working. So we're using RGB multiply to change color. I'll just show that real quickly as well. So we get our lines in the different color. And we can choose how thick our wires are just by controlling the gradient ramp. I'll make it a bit thicker now, and you can see if it's a sort of a different effect here after. You can do this as well. If you want them quite thin, you're just going to have to position it fairly to the edge of it. And just wait for it to render as all. And again, the result we're hopefully after. Now for the last part, the glow. If people are really interested in how to do that, we'll go to our render setup, and in the renderer tab, when using MentalRay, we'll enable the output shader. The default in this is a glare shader, so basically we can also, if we open our render setup as well, we can throw this in our material editor, and we've got controls for this. Basically what this does, anything that's kind of self-illuminating or like in the upper reaches of the image when it comes to brightness, it'll give a glow. So if we just render again with that enabled, you'll see the glow doesn't show up yet. It's a post-render effect, so it'll take a second to calculate afterwards. And there it is. So for anyone wanting to use this effect, I hope this tutorial is a little helpful. And I guess that's it for me. I'll see you next time.